Start on your back with your soles of your feet together and your knees falling wide towards the side. You can have little pillows or blocks underneath your knees or thighs to make sure there's no discomfort in your lower back or your knees. And then bring one hand on your belly and one hand on your heart. Start to bring your awareness towards the breath. Just observing how it rises, how it falls. I'm not changing the breath yet. Let your face relax completely. Your shoulders drop down into the ground. And stretch your arms out overhead on your inhalation. Fill the lungs with air. And when you exhale, interlace the fingers behind your head, lengthen the neck, and let the elbows just fall out towards the side like you're on the beach. Keep that relaxed feeling. Take a deep inhalation. And when you exhale, lift the shoulders and the head away from the ground. Inhale down, exhale up. So just in a very relaxed way, activating your core muscles slightly. Inhaling down and exhaling up. A few more. Exhale. Keep the face soft, the neck long. And just stay a little longer up and relax down. Stretch the arms out overhead. Let that little fire spread throughout your body. And then remove the pillows or blocks if they were underneath your knees. And bring the arms out on shoulder height. Bring the knees to one side. And then take the opposite arm all the way over your chest, beyond your hand. And then stretch out open towards the side again. So inhale, rolling the arm beyond your other hand. Exhale, slowly bring it back open, twisting a little more. So here you just ease your way into the pose, into the twist. You can have the head completely relaxed onto the ground and just let it roll with your movement. And make sure you have long, nice, deep in and exhalations. And this time you just stay open with your arm. And just breathe into your back and your belly. And from there, bring the knees back to center and over towards the other side. The same thing, the opposite arm comes over the chest, beyond your hand, and exhale, bring it back open. It's like you're peeling your hand and then your arm, your shoulder away from the ground, and stretching it out towards the other side. Make sure your knees are relaxed and your face is relaxed. More like this. And this time you stay open with your arm. You can gaze over to that hand if that feels comfortable for your neck. And just observe your breath again. Start to lift your knees to the center and place them down onto the ground. Straighten your legs out. Straighten your arms out above your head. Give yourself a nice little stretch and then feel your arms, your shoulders, your back all the way away from the ground and sit up straight. The sit bones are on the ground. Lengthen your spine, crown of the head reaches up. And then a relaxed forward fold, so no reaching with the shoulders, only with the hands. And it doesn't matter if you can hold your feet or not. It's just about folding forward, releasing the spine. But at the same time, keeping a little activation in your legs. So you've got lots of space here to breathe into the back. And then you're slowly going to roll up to sitting again. And transition to your next pose. So make sure you've got some space behind you to roll back. And then bring the legs all the way overhead, as straight as possible. Interlace the fingers behind your back. And then place the hands as high up towards the shoulders as you can. And then you lift the legs into shoulder stand. So if you've never done this before, it might feel a little strange. You can just adjust your pose and modify it by lowering your buttocks a little bit towards your hands. So then you would be not completely straight, but that's fine. So make sure there is still some space to breathe in your chest. See if you can move the chin slightly away from the chest. If you have any claustrophobic feeling, try that. Try to move the chin slightly away from the chest. And keep your gaze towards your toes, or towards the ceiling, just a relaxed gaze. And it's already time to lower your legs again. And roll your spine, vertebra by vertebra, all the way down towards the ground. So make it a little core exercise. Keep the face relaxed, shoulders relaxed. And if you can, keep your legs straight while you lower your legs completely down. Good. Now place the hands underneath the buttocks, arch the spine, and place the crown of the head onto the ground for fish pose. Make sure the shoulders are rolled under. And just take a look at the world upside down. Still, your breath is full and deep, but relaxed. Lift out of the pose the way you came in, and then bring your knees slowly towards the chest. You can make little circles to relax the lower back muscles. And then slowly move towards happy baby pose, with your knees towards your shoulders. The arms on the insides of your legs, and see if you can, from there, grab the outside of your feet. If that's not possible for you today, then just bend your knees and keep your knees a little wider so that you can bring your arms around your knees like loose ribbons. And in both poses, you can gently rock from side to side, relaxing the muscles around your spine. Keep it a little soft and gentle. Slowly release that pose. Interlace the fingers around your knees and give yourself a nice little hug. And then let the knees fall towards one side and see if you can straighten the top leg and maybe grab that foot or that thigh with the other hand. Don't worry if it doesn't work for you. You can just have your knees bend, and that's already a nice twist. And both knees back to the center, shift towards the other side, and maybe straighten the top leg. So just take it easy. No strain, no stress. And then let that go. Bring your knees back to center. Then you can choose to stay in the pose that we started in. So that's when your feet together and your knees falling towards the sides, maybe with some support underneath the knees. Or you can straighten out the legs like a regular shavasana. So then your legs will be completely straight with the feet falling towards the side. So choose a position that feels good for you and that you can stay in for a while. So if there was any tension in your body, in your muscles or your brain, start to release and soften those places. So you can imagine melting down like a little ice cube, relaxing your face, your hands, your feet, and everything in between. And take a moment to observe your mind. Observe your thoughts. And just let them float like little clouds in a blue sky. You can stay in this pose for as long as you like. Or you can slowly straighten out your legs. Remove any blocks or props, and roll onto your right side. And from there, press yourself back to sitting. Take a cross-leg position that feels comfortable. And then bring your hands in front of your heart. Dedicate your practice to someone that is dear to you. Namaste.